Hi, in previous two episodes we discussed about TDD and BDD, but now today we'll discuss the difference or the comparison. So TDD actually is a test driven development, whereas BDD is behavior driven development. So TDD is more like unit testing, where we test each method, and for every method then we write actual code. Whereas BDD is more like end-to-end test, or for testing each scenario. So the scope is different, and then based on the testing test case, test method or test scenario, we write the actual code. Behavior end-to-end scenario can be written by business user, whereas in TDD those tests are written by the developers, because that's more close to the code instead of to the human behavior or human aspect of the system. So TDD, from the requirement we write, in both cases from the requirement we write the test, and from the test we write the development or complete the development part. So that's the flow in both the cases. In TDD, it's the developer interpretation of the requirements, whereas in BDD it's the business analyst or the product owner interpretation of the requirement. So is TDD only possible for calculator example? No, you have to be trained. This is a mind shift. It's not just only for the simple application. You can really write TDD for very, very complex system, but it requires the skill to understand, to perceive how the things is going to happen, how the implementation would be. Even before writing the actual code, you have to perceive it, you have to predict how you have to write, and it can be achieved very easily by practice, by doing it again and again, and training that part of your brain where you first think about what to test and then to write the actual behavior. Can we really adopt TDD in REST API? Yes, we can adopt, but again it will depend on the organization, the culture, how they want to do it. Generally, in the organization, it is a norm. They first write all the REST API because they want to provide those API in terms of resources. So the resources has certain operation, CRUD operation, and then it's really easy when you are thinking about certain solution in terms of resources, and those resources have CRUD operation like put, patch, post, get, etc. So what is BDT? This is a behavior driven testing. And how it is different from the TDD and BDD, let's look at this example. So generally here I have shown different path that different organization or product company follow. Here we look at the requirement, and there would be certain product or companies which just directly write the code from the requirement and then deliver this thing, that's it. Another company could be, or a product that write code from the requirement, and then based on that code they write test, and they do some iteration to calibrate the quality of the system, and once they are satisfied with the test, then this is delivered. So this is the classic way of the development, where you write the code from the requirement and then you write the test and then deliver. So this is mostly or widely adopted by different product companies or software companies. Whereas this is the negligence path. You should never ever go for this. If you are feeling like there's a certain company which always force you in every project, in every product, then it's time to switch from here or go to the product owner and talk to him, and you have to convince him or her like why the quality is important, why writing test is really important. This is your test. This is about you. This is your quality if you cannot convince someone. So another third stream is where TDD is implemented. You write the test first from the requirement, and then from the test you write the code, and that code is then delivered. And obviously you can have iteration, because as you proceed you will have more and more clear understanding, and based on that you will update your test, and then from the test you will update your code, and you will do it iteratively until you are satisfied to deliver the product. And then finally, there is a behavior driven development, where you identify the behaviors, human aspect of the system, the scenarios, and then based on this, those scenario, you write the test, and from the test then you write the code. And again, you can calibrate the code. It is again an iterative process where you fix, you think that there is certain thing which need to be tested or certain functionality that need to be provided. So first you write the test for that thing, and then you write the code, and you do it again and again until you are satisfied to deliver the product. So these are four different streams which are adopted by industry. Okay, now another technique which is used widely by smart company or agile companies, they try to do something like this, where the development is done with the TDD process. TDD process is test driven development. From the requirement, developer write test, and from the test they write code, and iterative process, finally they deliver this package. And for the testing part, behaviors are written. Behaviors are the scenarios, and based on those scenario, tests are written, and then these tests execute or verify the final delivery. So these two combination, mix of combination, make a very well technique for an agile company to run the TDD test but perform behavior driven testing. So that's the difference between TDD, test driven development, BDD, behavior driven development, and which is BDT, which is behavior driven testing. That's it for today. I will see you in the next episode. Thank you. Bye.